Surah 5:48. And unto thee have we revealed the scripture with the truth, confirming whatever scripture was before it, and a watcher over it. So judge between them by that which Allah hath revealed, and follow not their desires away from the truth which hath come unto thee. For each we have appointed a divine law and a traced out way. Had Allah willed, he could have made you one community. But that he may try you by that which he hath given you, he hath made you as you are. So vie one with another unto good works. Unto Allah you will all return, and he will then inform you of that wherein you differ. So vie one with another in good works. That's Allah's command, O Muslim. You are supposed to vie with me unto good works. Because, well, I can't help it. Allah made me this way. You do believe the word of Allah, right? Had Allah willed, he could have made you one community. But that he may try you by that which he has given you, he hath made you as you are. Quran 29:46. And do not argue with the followers of the book, except by what is best, save with those of them who act unjustly and say, We believe in that which has been revealed to us and revealed to you, and our God and your God is one, and to him do we submit. So do not argue with the followers of the book, except by what is best. That's Allah's command, O Muslim. You must only argue with good, rational arguments, that which is best. So this is your chance, O Muslim, to convince me. I know you claim your prophet confirmed the message of the Injil. Well, to me, that means your prophet must have taught the same thing, right? So I would like to study with you and show you the things Jesus taught in the Injil. And I would like you to tell me where in the Quran Mohammed taught the same thing. So this is your chance, O Muslim, to teach me where Mohammed taught the same message as Jesus. Matthew 5:42. You have heard that it has been said, Thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thine enemy. But I, Jesus, say unto you, Love your enemies. Bless them that curse you, do good unto them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. I always get encouraged by this passage. It shows that God's true path is so much higher than our natural human behavior. Surely there must be a passage from Allah that Muhammad revealed that also showed this same purity, this same holiness. Matthew 5:39. You have heard that it has been said, An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I, Jesus, say unto you, that you resist not evil, but whosoever shall smite you on your right cheek, turn to him the other also. I always get encouraged by this passage also. It shows that God's true path is so much higher than our natural human responses and behavior. Surely, if Muhammad taught the same message from the same God, he said this same thing somewhere in the Quran, right? Well, I'd really appreciate it if anyone from Islam can show me where Muhammad also taught this same message he claimed he confirmed. John 3:16, For God so loved the world. Beautiful. Such glorious love by Almighty God. For God so loved the world. Surely the Quran must speak of God's love for the world, right? After all, Muhammad brought the same message as Jesus, right? And Muhammad is supposed to have been the seal, the last, the final prophet. Surely in Muhammad's Quran, he affirmed and repeated the message Allah had sent by previous prophets. So if one of you brothers in Islam who respect Allah can tell me where Muhammad also carried this same message, I'd really appreciate it. In fact, if Muhammad brought the same message as Jesus and the prophets, he would look a lot like a prophet to me. So if you could please find the surah where Muhammad also repeated this message, that would be great. For God so loved the world. And it would really make me excited about Prophet Muhammad if you could find him revealing the whole message, including that which Jesus said right after, "For God so loved the world." For God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son. I'm sure that since Prophet David and Prophet Solomon and Prophet Isaiah and Prophet Jesus all spoke of the Son of God, Prophet Muhammad also confirmed the Son of God. Surely Muhammad, the last prophet, the final prophet who confirmed their message, would also speak of God's Son. And if anyone in Islam can show me surah and ayat where Muhammad repeated the message of the prophets about God's Son, I'd like you to share it. I just know that Muhammad, being a prophet from the God who sent the prophets, the God who never changes, Muhammad would have the same message and also confirm the Son of God. And a big howdy to my brothers in Saudi Arabia. Surely you have the access to the best records of Muhammad's words. Surely you who keep the holy site Mecca, you have his original words, right? Surely you can vie with the people of the book and share the many places Muhammad also taught the same things that Jesus taught. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Glory to Almighty God! Rejoice, O Muslim! Almighty God has sent his Son to save the world. This is the message Jesus taught in the true Injil. I'm sure since Muhammad was a prophet of the same God, Muhammad must have confirmed what Jesus said, right? So if someone from Islam can do some study in the original Arabic of the Quran, I'd love to learn where Prophet Muhammad also told of God sending his Son to save the world. So thank you in advance to each Muslim who honors the Quran enough to study and find these for me. I'm sure that once someone from Islam can find these and show me that the Quran also has the same message, that Muhammad also said and taught the same things about God and God's love, I will have a whole new respect for Muhammad. So go back through this video if you need to, just to make sure you find the same message. We want to make sure that Muhammad is teaching the same message as Jesus actually taught. I'm not sure what I would think if no one from Islam can find this message in their Quran. I mean, if Muhammad did not repeat the message of Jesus and of the prophets, that would be a clear sign, a red flag that none should ignore. But I've heard that Muhammad confirmed the Torah and Injil, so he must have repeated their message. After all, God had four other prophets all speak of the Son of God. That means God thought it was important enough to repeat several times. And like a piece of advice from a loving father right before a separation, he would whisper, "I love you, and remember. Remember the important things I've told you before." I really think that God would repeat the previous revelations in his final whisper before a long silence. Don't you? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.